morning, y'all.
Beautiful day. Sun's hitting me right in the face. We are on, today is June 1st, 2022. And we are cranking out more miles because we have the Father's Day 5K on, I think it's the 19th. And just overall summer training, so we up it a little bit. We're going to be doing 6 miles total today in the morning. I already ran 5. Last one is a cool down, so I just kind of fast-paced walk. Really good run this morning. We started adding some hill work into my training. There's a hill on the way to my job called Hell Hill, and it just is a stupid incline. But probably about a week ago, I started really trying to run the whole thing. And I finally was able to do so. And now I've done it consistently, pretty much every day now for the past week. Today was the first time that, excuse me, that I could run at a good pace from my house all the way to work and then just kept going. I went 2 full miles at a pretty good pace. I wasn't looking at the watch to know. I know it was under 10 minutes, but had a really good pace for me and didn't have to take a breather or stop or slow down or anything. So I'm pretty damn proud of myself of that. I actually did almost 3 straight without having to like do a fast walk stoppage for a minute. After I got to that point, we kind of slowed down the pace a little bit just so that I could stay consistent, because I'm trying to get better at the long run. I like to do a lot of research to try and, you know, maximize my potential for my age. I'm 42, gonna be 43 soon, so, you know, anything I can do to better myself at this, I'm gonna do as fast as I can, because unlike other runners that are my age, I haven't been doing it for the past 20 years, 25 years. I'm very new. I've only been doing it for a little over a year. And I gotta tell myself that sometimes, because I do try and set unreasonable goals. And that's a little bit about what this rant is about, or jaywalk series. By the way, this is episode 6, but you got to set yourself reasonable goals, things that you can actually achieve. It's not bad to set your expectations a little high sometimes, but if you do so, just make sure that you're also reminding yourself that you set yourself a far goal if you haven't gotten to it in the expected time. Because it can be discouraging if you don't. And I just don't want to see anybody be self-defeating when they're trying to accomplish something they're setting out for. And I even got to remind myself that sometimes. Because, like I said, you know, I haven't been running an overly long time. And you can't expect unrealistic results without putting in the work. And there's just a ton of people that have put in the work way longer than I have. that are going to outshine me. Now, does that mean I can't try? And does that mean that I can't try and push myself to be better? No, not at all. There's a reason that I've placed in a couple of races now. I even got first in my age group when I did the Lake Norman 5K last year, which I did not expect, but you know, it happens. There was only 4 people in my age group, but fact is, I did better than 3 other people, and that's enough for me. And kudos to anyone who went and did it. You know, like, props to everyone that's out there getting it in, staying healthy, staying active. I'm just saying that, you know, that day I happened to do better than 3 other people in my age bracket, and I'll take that. This upcoming Father's Day 5K, I'm aiming to try and place in that one too. Whether that'll happen or not, I don't know, but I'm damn sure gonna try. And I got one thing in my advantage, that's the race is really flat this time. The Mother's Day one was at a different spot, and that had a bunch of hills and all that crap. And I mean, I still killed my previous personal best of almost, it was just under 28 minutes the last 5K I did. This one, I did just over 27. So, Father's Day 5K, we're aiming. I'm really gonna try, but we're aiming to try and get 25 or lower. I did a training run about 2 weeks ago by my job, and like, I'm gonna say I'm pretty sure that my watch did not pick that up right, because it said that I did a 5K in a little over 24 minutes, and I don't want to doubt myself, but I really pulled apart the map that I did that day, and there was just a couple discrepancies that didn't make sense. And I'm trying to be honest with myself. There's no point of lying to try and put myself on a pedestal so that I can, like I said earlier, disappoint myself in the future. So the goal for the next one is to try and get under 25 minutes. I'd really like to place. That would be great. If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. But if I can at least get in the 26s, that would be amazing. Because that means that my times are getting lower and lower. And that means I'll be in the 8-minute range for my pace for a 5K, which I'll take. Like, if I can sustain 8-ish minute miles, maybe a little over, for 3 miles straight, I'll take that. Again, you know, I haven't been doing this very long, and I was overweight my whole life, so any kind of progress I'll take. But we got the Father's Day 5K coming up in a couple weeks. I've got the American 4-miler coming up, 4th of July. It's either going to be that or the Firecracker 5K. I gotta really look, but then we have in August, we have the Asheville 10K that me and my wife are going to be doing together. And that one we're going to actually go to Asheville and do. Then September, we got Around the Crown, which is 10K in Charlotte. Pretty cool. They block off the highway. You get to go and run on 277. And then we have, I want to say Around the Crown is before Lake Hinson. Lake Hinson is a 24-hour race. It's pretty much a loop around a lake, and you do as much as you want or as little as you want in 24 hours. And me and my wife are doing that. October, may be doing either the, I think it's the Sunset Beach half marathon. And we're kind of, it's a toss up right now. It's either going to be the Sunset Beach half marathon, or it's going to be the scare run for Halloween, where we get to dress up. November, we got the Turkey Trot, which me and my wife will probably be doing together. And then December, we got the Santa Run. So we got the whole year planned out. At least one race a month, staying consistent. Up to this point, I think I got in the past year, maybe a little over a year, I've gotten in 20 races so far. And we're just gonna keep pushing. Next year, I'm gonna aim for my first full marathon next year. I don't want to jump in too early. I want to make sure that my body is ready to handle 26.2 miles. Be stupid to jump into that and not be prepared for it. We also are planning on doing another 100K step challenge soon. I don't know exactly when, because I got a lot of races coming up and I don't want to hurt myself for those. Last time I did 100,000 steps in a day, my left Achilles tendon was screaming at me for a couple weeks. So the last thing I want to do is something that doesn't have any kind of reward at the end, because I've already done it, just to hurt myself in the long run and put myself behind with races, because my training is so that I can go forward, not behind. But we'll wrap this up. I got to get in and get a shower and get my day ready. Catch y'all later. Until the next episode of Jaywalks. If you think I'm worth your time, go ahead and hit the like button. And if you think I'm really worth it, go ahead and subscribe. Follow the series. It's just pretty much me working my way up to better running and fitness and health and weight loss tips.